Hello everyone. So we will continue with the course Evaluation of Textile Material. In last section we have started the measurement of characteristics of textile material. We have started with the one of the most important characteristics of staple fiber, that is the length. There we have discussed various length related parameters and their uniformity related parameters, and also we have discussed various methods of measurements. And now we will discuss another important parameter of textile material, textile fiber. This characteristics is that its fiber fineness. So, in most of the material, the fineness like cylindrical material, the fineness can be easily expressed by diameter. So in that case, fiber also it should be actually the diameter should be the one of the parameters. We should be able to measure the diameter. So, fineness means that how small or large the diameter of a fiber is. So, we would like to know the finer or coarser, whether the fiber is fine or coarse. So, we would like to know by measuring the fineness. By fineness we know that it is a basically cross sectional shape. If a fiber is fine, the cross sectional area should be less, but most of the textile material, textile fiber, the main problem is that it is a basically it is not uniform. Now, by knowing the fiber fineness, so we would like to know the various actually process related parameters. So, if a given count is spun from a fine or coarse fiber, so more uniformity we will get, higher uniformity and stronger yarn we will get from the finer fiber. Because in case of finer fiber, so for same yarn linear density, if we use finer fiber, that means the number of fibers in the cross section will be high. So, higher number of fiber in the cross section will result the higher uniformity, and also the higher number of fiber will have more and more contact points, higher contact points, that will result for the same fiber strength. Fiber strength is keeping same, so fiber tenacity keeping same. But if we use fibers with smaller diameter, that will result higher contact area and will have stronger yarn. Like we can see here the two yarns, this is one yarn, the two yarns are there, yarn A and yarn B. So, the yarn count of the two yarns are exactly same, but yarn A we are preparing, we are making the yarn A by using coarser fiber. So, number of fibers in the cross section will be less, but yarn B we are using finer fiber. So, this is the number of fiber. So, the number of fibers will be very high. So, if we use the smaller fibers, finer fiber with smaller diameter. So, here in yarn B, as the number of fibers are more, so the uniformity of yarn is actually will be very high that means evenness, the CV percent will be low because it is a inversely proportional to the number of fiber. As the number of fiber increases, the CV will reduce. Okay. Also, if we see, if we compare yarn A and yarn B, as the number of fibers are more, so higher contact area between fiber to fibers are there. So, and in yarn A, as its coarser fibers are there, so contact area between fiber to fiber contact area will be much less than in case of B. So, the between fiber contact area, if it increases, that means its frictional contact will increase. So, as we know, the staple fiber yarn strength comes from only the friction. So, if this A and B are from same staple fiber of different diameter fibers. So, yarn A, as it has got less contact area, for keeping all other parameters same, the yarn A will result lower strength. So, this yarn B will have higher strength and lower irregularity, that is higher uniformity will be there. So, it is obvious that now, so that with the by using finer fiber, we can achieve the stronger yarn and uniform yarn. So, it is very important to know the diameter of fiber. Okay. Finer fiber can be spun to finer yarn count, okay, than coarser fiber, because for yarn to be manufactured, to be actually produced, we need minimum number of fibers in the cross section. So, if a finer yarn we want to produce, in that case we have to use finer fiber. Like again we can come here, you can see this is yarn, we have to, this is a certain count of yarn. Okay. Suppose this is yarn is say English count, say 10 English count, we are using one particular fiber. Okay. So, that is working here because number of fibers are required fibers are there, it is a coarser count. Okay. Now, suppose we want to produce a finer count, say 60s count, 60s count yarn we want to produce, and the yarn diameter is this one. Now, here if we want to use the same fiber, so number of fiber will be very less. So, yarn we cannot form yarn, if at all the yarn is formed, the yarn will be highly irregular and strength will be very less. So, to produce finer yarn, so if we want to produce finer yarn, then we have to use the very fine fiber. So, by using finer fiber, we can produce finer yarn and getting very good quality. So, a finer yarn can be produced from finer fiber. The fineness affects the, now we will see the what is the importance of fineness of fiber and what are its effect on different characteristics. So, it affects various characteristics. First is that it affects the stiffness, handle and drape of fabric. Okay. So, the bending rigidity of fiber increases with the diameter. Okay. As the fiber diameter increases, the its bending rigidity will increase. So, the bending rigidity of fabric or its stiffness will also increase, and it affects the drape characteristics. So, to have very soft fabric, very soft handle, highly drapeable fabric, we must use a finer fiber. Thus, for a yarn of given count, the flexibility increases as the fiber diameter decreases. So, if we use the coarser fiber, the stiffness of the yarn will increase. Now, coming to the torsional rigidity. So, torsional rigidity increases with the increase in fiber diameter. Okay. The resistance to twist with the increase with the increase is increase in the diameter of fiber. That means, if we want to produce yarn with very coarse fiber. So, that means, the fiber due to its torsional rigidity and high bending rigidity, that will not actually follow the helix of the yarn. Okay. Now, let us see what happens if we use the coarser fiber. So, if we use the coarser fiber, what happens? Suppose this is yarn, we want to twist. Okay. Now, if we use the finer fiber, when we apply twist, that will follow the helix, and also it will follow the migration behavior, whatever may be during the twisting. But if we want to twist the coarser fiber, due to its high torsional rigidity, it will not be twisted easily. So, that it will not follow the helix also, that this fiber will come out from the structure, surface structure. So, that will result hairiness. Okay. So, that means, for coarser fiber, from coarser fiber it is very difficult to twist. So, for spinning, staple fiber spinning, we have to go for the finer fiber. Okay. So, twisting is a problem. Thus, it is easier to twist finer fiber than coarser one in yarn spinning. So therefore, if it is given option, two fibers are there, that is of keeping all other parameters same, the fiber with lower diameter we must always select for spinning, because the spinability of that fiber with lower diameter is much better than the coarser fiber. Now, light reflectance also changes with the diameter of fiber. For a given yarn count and fabric weight, finer fibers give greater number of reflecting surface, because it is a finer the fiber, higher is the specific surface area. So, more reflecting surface will be there in case of finer fiber. Thus, finer fiber tend to yield a soft sheen, it will give a soft glitter, soft brightness, it will give soft sheen, but coarser fiber will give harsh glitter, because from a particular surface it will reflect, it will start reflecting. So, harsh glitter it will give, other things being equal. Also, using finer fiber, the light reflectance characteristics can be changed. Because, so if we use finer fiber, we can produce same characteristics of yarn by imparting less amount of twist. So, if we see, this is this is coarse fiber. Okay. Due to this other characteristics, like your higher more surface area, more contact area. Okay. So, higher strength availability, using finer fiber we can impart less amount of twist to have same quality of yarn. But if we want to get the same strength or same other characteristics, for coarser fiber we have to impart higher amount of twist. So, this fiber arrangement for in the yarn for finer fiber, it is more or less parallel to the axis, close to parallel to the axis, at less quantity of less amount of twist we can impart. So, that means, this fiber surface, the yarn surface is can reflect better in case of finer fiber, because of the less amount of twist, less helix. So, that means, the yarn made of the finer fiber will be lustrous, will actually will have better look. But if we impart higher twist, that means the yarn will be little bit dull in nature. So, that is why it is when we use the finer fiber, we always use less twist, and it also helps not only in the look, it also helps in the productivity. So, if we impart, if we get the same characteristics by imparting the less amount of twist in ring frame, that means it the productivity delivery rate is higher. Okay. Front roller delivery speed will be higher for keeping the same spindle speed. So, in dyeing the dyed fabric, finer fibers give lighter shade than coarser fiber, because it is a depth of that the amount of dye uptake is higher in case of coarser fiber. Okay. So, that in that way, if depending on our requirement of depth of shade, we may select the finer fiber or coarser fiber. So, if we need a depth, higher depth, so we can go for little bit coarser fiber. So, that is why it is very important to measure the length of fiber diameter, absorption of liquid. Okay. Finer fibers have relatively more surface area than coarse fiber for given mass. So, its specific surface area is more than the coarser fiber, that is why the finer fiber absorbs more liquid, it's a higher quantity of liquid and it absorbs faster. So, that is why its dye uptake is high, wicking is very fast, that is why the fabric where high wickability is required, we use finer fiber. Its wickability is high and it depends on the fiber fineness. Fiber to fiber cohesion, the surface contact area, as I have already mentioned, area of finer fiber is greater in yarn. So, that is why it results stronger yarn. So, twist results in friction between fibers, and this is greater for finer fiber than coarser fiber. So, that increase in friction by increasing twist is effect is more in case of finer fiber than coarser fiber. And other thus other things being equal, for a given yarn count, less twist is needed for finer fibers than coarser fiber, that we have discussed. And this less twist will result better look, better luster, better uniformity, less hairiness, and that your better wickability. Okay, that even it will give the equivalent strength. Okay, and evenness of yarn. So, yarn evenness increases with the decrease in fiber diameter, because number of fibers in the cross section is more when for the same yarn count when we use finer fiber. So, for a given yarn count, more fibers in the cross section, better is the uniformity, that we know. Thus, other things being equal, fine fibers give better uniformity than coarse fibers. So, coarse fiber, if we see, it gives less uniformity. And so, if we see the limit irregularity of the yarn is expressed by V r is the limiting irregularity square, that is the irregularity standard deviation square or C v square of that yarn is the 100 square divided by n. Okay. So, n is the in denominator and V m square by n. The V m is the irregularity of individual fiber, mass irregularity of individual fiber. So, in the yarn, if we see that the irregularity of the yarn decreases with number of fiber. So, as the number of fiber increase, that means number of fiber we can increase for the same yarn count by reducing the diameter of fiber. So, measurement of fiber fineness cannot be done by measuring the diameter. So, in other engineering material, if we want to measure the fineness for normal say iron rod or say anything, any if we want to know the even wear, so metallic wear, if we want to measure the fineness, it is expressed in terms of diameter, because that diameter is measurement of diameter of any wear. Okay, it is a metallic wear, it is possible by measuring the, because it is a uniform in nature throughout the length, the diameter is almost uniform. Okay, and most of the cases the it is a circular in nature, the rod or the wire, they are circular in nature, that is why the by expressing the diameter we can measure the fineness. But main problem with textile fibers are, this is we can measure by diameter, so but in textile material we cannot measure, because the problem is that cross section of most of the fibers are not circular. So, we do not get the circular fiber except very few, like synthetic fiber it is okay, but synthetic fiber again we will see, although the if at all the spinneret is circular, but sometime we find that due to various thermomechanical characteristics, thermomechanical action, the circularity gets distorted. And also there are many other fibers, many other man-made fibers, their cross sections are not circular in nature, like trilobal or different type of special structure. So, these are not circular, and most of the natural fibers, they are not at all circular, except wool, wool has got little bit circular in cross section. So, that is why diameter measurement of fiber, it is not normally we can we do, and also the fibers diameter is very very small, it is very difficult to measure the diameter. So, it is in micron. So, measurement of diameter directly, it is sometime it creates problem. Okay. So, that is why we do not measure the in general, we measure the diameter of fiber as a parameter for fineness. So, cross section are not circular, and second problem is that variation in diameter along the length is very high. So, where to explain, where to express the fiber diameter? So, if we see the fiber cross section is not uniform, we cannot express, we cannot take the diameter, which diameter should we take? So, that is not the thickness, we it is non uniform. Another problem is that along the length fibers, the diameters are not uniform. Majority of the natural fiber, they grow like this. So, diameter expressing the diameter, it is very difficult, okay, because it is very highly variable, particularly for natural fiber. And third problem is that the cross sectional shape of fibers within a sample may not be uniform. So, if we see the cross section of say cotton fiber, so this is a cotton fiber, if we see a particular lot, we will see fiber with different cross sectional shape. So, there is no uniformity in the cross section, so different cross sectional shape. So, due to all these three problems, we normally do not take fiber diameter as a measure of fineness. Okay. Now, first problem was the cross section of most of the fibers are not circular. Let us see the cross section of normally known fibers. Okay. This is cotton, it is like bean type structure cross section. So, we cannot measure the diameter here, okay. And also it is a it's a very it varies from place to place. Okay. Silk, it is not circular, it is a trilobal type, a triangular type shape, cross section. Flax, it is little bit hexagonal type shape. So, we do not have any circular cross section. Okay. Wool, although wool is little bit on in the circular, that is why only in case of wool we express the fineness in terms of diameter. Wool only is the fiber where we express the fineness in terms of micron. Okay. That is why it is a circular in nature, but still the diameter variation of wool is very high, it is maybe 25% to 30% diameter variation, but still we can measure the diameter of wool fiber. See, this is synthetic fiber, acetate fiber, it is not circular. Rayon, serrated structure, so we cannot measure the diameter. And trilobal polyester, although circular polyesters are there, we can measure, but main problem, as I have mentioned, it is a very fine diameter, so measurement is difficult. Okay. Next is that variation in diameter along the length. So, along the length, if we see, for particularly for natural fiber, diameter varies. So, it is not good idea to measure the diameter. Okay. So, this is the ways. So, at different portion, this is cotton, at different portion if we see, the thickness changes. So, we cannot measure the diameter of the fiber. Wool, it is a different structure, okay, at different, but here although the in case of wool we take try to take the mean diameter in terms of micron, but if we see the for natural fiber the diameters are not uniform. The cross sectional shape of fibers within a sample may not be uniform. So, if we see, this is the cotton fiber, the cross sectional shape of cotton fiber, different cotton fibers are totally different, there is no uniformity. So, we do not normally do not measure the diameter here. So, the most convenient way of expressing the fiber fineness is by measuring the mass of known length, that is linear density. So, linear, our idea is to measure the cross sectional area of fiber. So, if we see the mass per unit area, unit length, sorry, mass per unit area length or linear density, it is proportional to the cross sectional shape. Let us see how. This is one fiber, for our convenience we have taken the cylindrical fiber, cylindrical shape, okay, and volume is the cross sectional shape, cross sectional area by length. So, mass equal to volume multiplied by density, and that is the cross sectional area multiplied by length, it is the volume and it is a density. So, mass per unit length m by l, mass by unit length, when for keeping the density constant for a particular fiber, density remains constant. So, we can say mass per unit length is proportional to the cross sectional area. Okay. This is the cross sectional area. So, that means, so it is justified that if we measure the mass per unit length, whether it is a circular or not does not matter, the mass per unit length is always proportional to the cross sectional area. Okay. So, that mass per unit length gives the idea about the cross sectional area for a same fiber. That means, the fiber with higher mass per unit length will have higher cross sectional area. So, how to express the fiber fineness? We can express the fiber fineness in terms of tex, okay, that is in direct system, it is a tex, it is a mass in gram of 1000 meter of yarn or fiber. Okay. So, most of the fiber fineness are expressed in the direct system, it is a mass per unit length we need to measure. So, decitex, it is a Desitex is tex is normally used for yarn, and desitex normally we use for fiber. It is a smaller in unit, that means mass in gram per 10,000 meter of fiber. So, that is the desitex. Denier is the mass in gram of 9,000 meter. So, 9 kilometer fiber will have that mass. Suppose desitex is x. So, if we take the 9, there's a denier is x. If we take 9 kilometer of yarn, the mass will be the say x gram. Okay. But this tex, desitex or denier, they are normally used for synthetic fiber, say man made fibers. And for cotton, there is another system, it is called micronier. Micronier is expressed in terms of, it is a mass in microgram per 1 inch. For 1 inch of fiber, what is the if we take the mass, that will be micronier. Okay. And we can convert micronier to denier, denier to tex, their conversion is simple. That means, by measuring the micronier of cotton, we can actually measure the cross sectional area. Now, desitex we can calculate directly using this formula, and where rho is the density of fiber in gram per cc and d is the diameter in microgram. So, if we know the desitex and density of fiber, we can calculate the diameter or vice versa, and this is for circular fiber, assuming the fiber is circular in nature. But desitex is actually proportional to the square of diameter. So, let us see what will be the desitex of a polyester fiber of diameter 12 micron. So, diameter is given, it is a 12 micron diameter is given. So, we would like to know the desitex or denier of the. So, by using this formula directly, we can measure the desitex. Okay. The density of polyester is 1.38 gram per cc, diameter is given, it is in 12 micron. So, desitex will be this one, using this here diameter is in micron. Okay. Directly we use. So, this is the desitex of fiber. So, directly we can measure. So, this type of problem we can actually solve by directly by using the formula. Now, we have to now select, there are various methods of measurement. We have to select which methods are to be actually adopted. Okay. What are the methods we have to adopt? Okay. So, these methods depend on the various factors. First is the physical form of fiber, okay. Whether it is a raw fiber in bale form, in the form of sliver, or if it is from the roving or from the yarn or even from the fabric. So, if we want to measure the fiber diameter or fiber fineness from fabric, so we will not be able to get a large quantity of fiber. On the other hand, if we have large quantity of fiber, we can use a particular method. Okay. And if we have very few fibers, we can use different methods. And also there are methods which we can get directly, and another method we can get indirectly the fiber cross sectional area. It is necessary to assess. So, is it necessary to assess the fineness of individual fiber from the bulk? So, do we want to measure the fineness of individual fiber, or is it necessary to assess overall fineness of a batch of fiber in the bulk? So, if we want to know the overall fineness, we have to adopt different method. If we want to measure the fiber fineness of individual fiber, then we have to adopt different method. So, methods depending on these factors. First is that gravimetric method of measuring the fiber fineness. Okay. It is basically, it is by taking the mass of fiber. From the Combe-Schottard diagram, fiber tufts are taken at a spacing of 1 centimeter tuft, okay, selected or sliced out with the help of razor. Now, let us see. This is Combe-Schottard diagram. From here, we are measuring, we are taking out the fiber. This is few fiber we are taking, and after say 1 centimeter distance, this is the 1 centimeter distance, we are taking another set of fiber, okay. And these fibers we are, whatever number of fibers we are taking from this, after 1 centimeter another set we are trying to take, okay. Now, this segment of fibers we are, when we have taken, so this is the segment, these are the fibers we have taken out, and then we are slicing the edge to make it uniform, okay, to make it uniform. So, this is the actual fiber thing. From here also we are taking this fibers and then again cutting it, okay. And here also it is a smaller one and we are cutting it. From here also we are taking smaller fiber and then we are cutting it, okay. Now, from different portions we have taken, and then what we are doing, and it is a sliced out with the help of razor, then 100 fibers are counted and weighed on a sensitive microbalance, okay. At different places we are taking, so we know the length of individual fiber, and such 100 fibers we are counting, and then we are taking the mass. So, we want to measure the actually mass per unit length. So, we know the length, individual 100 fibers we know the individual fibers length, and then we can measure the mass. Why are we taking from the different zone? Because the longer fiber for cotton, the longer fiber will have higher diameter always. The longer fiber, it is a mature fiber, that is why normally it is a natural fiber, it is a little bit higher diameter, and short fiber is little bit immature fiber or not fully grown. So, that these fibers will be normally, it is a lower in diameter, to make it average out, to average out. So, we take the fibers from different source, different position. So, short fiber and long fiber also, and then we are getting the mean fiber linear density, okay, and convert it to mass per unit length. Next is that same method, gravimetric method for wool fiber. This is little bit different, where wool has almost circular in cross section. So, we know the wool fiber, it is a circular cross section. So, we can measure either mass per unit length or measure the diameter. So, after completing the fiber length test, the fibers are collected and thoroughly cleaned of oil, because during fiber length test, when we take the fiber from the comber or from the cutting, so it contains oil. So, oil content if it is there, so it will affect the diameter of fiber. So, that is why we have to clean the fiber and then dry, and we have to allow it to condition. So, after conditioning, then we have to take the weight in the microbalance. Okay. Now, the total length is sigma h n, okay. That means is calculated knowing the number of fibers in each group, and then the fiber mass per unit area unit length is derived. Now, this is suppose it is for wool fiber, length. So, we take from different length group. So, this is one length group, this is another length group, okay. So, the length group range should be around say 3 millimeter. So, around say 3 millimeter range length group fibers or mass per unit area. So, this length groups are there, here this is another length group, here we have another length group. So, in this length group, the length group here the length is say h, okay, h length, okay, h 1 is the length, and here number of fibers n 1. This length is say h 2 and here number of fibers n 2. Here it is a h 3 and number of fibers n 3. So, in this way we can take n number of groups. So, here in this length group, what is the total fiber length? N 1 into h 1 is the total fiber length. In this group, what is the fiber length? N 2 into h 2, N 3 into h 3, and so on. So, if we add all this thing, all these groups, so N h, this shows the total length of fiber. Total length of fiber, and if we take the mass of all these groups, then it will be the mass, if its mass is w, then it will be mass per unit length, okay. That is the fineness of fiber. Now, we can see in gravimetric method of wool, the total mass of all mass of fibers of all classes, it is in milligram, and h is the class length in centimeter, that particular class we want to take, and n is the number of fiber in that particular class, each class. Okay. So, in that way we can calculate the mass per unit length. Now, here mass per unit length is of the unit milligram per centimeter. Milligram per centimeter is the unit here, okay, mass per unit length. Now, as wool is circular in cross section, as we have mentioned, this wool fiber, this we can get, we can convert this mass per unit length into diameter of fiber. This diameter is known as gravimetric diameter. So, there are two types of diameters, one is direct diameter of wool fiber, another way is that gravimetric diameter. If we know the mass per unit length of fiber, then we can convert it to gravimetric diameter. Here W unit is milligram and length unit is centimeter. Now, let us see how to convert, how do we get this constant 97190, okay. Now, if we see, this is the fiber, okay, total fiber length, and the cross section is a pi d square by 4, okay. D is in micron, we want to know in micron, okay. Length, total length, what is the total length? H n is the total length of the fiber, then cross section area and length, that is this gives the volume of the fiber, this is giving the volume of the fiber. If we multiply by the density, we will get the mass fiber, mass in say milligram, okay. And now here it is given the dense, it is as per this formula we have seen, this unit is that micron square, because diameter in micron, length unit was in centimeter, density unit was in gram per cc, and mass unit was in milligram. This was the unit given. Now, what we are trying? We are trying to get the this constant. Now, density is 1.31, density of wool is 1.31 gram per cc. Okay. Now, if we see here, the if we try to convert in terms of say centimeters, so this if we convert pi d square by 4 d square into 10 to the power minus 4, that means centimeter square, it is, that is 10 to the power 5 minus 4 means it is a, and it will come into square, that is it is a in from micron to centimeter square, micron square to centimeter square we have converted. So, it is becoming centimeter square unit. Okay. Now, it is centimeter unit. So, this is, this remains same, this is centimeter unit, okay, that means centimeter cube, and this unit is gram per cc, rho remains same, okay, and this is this, that means total unit here it is becoming gram. So, we have to convert it in terms of gram, W by 1000, that means W by 1000, this unit becomes gram. Okay. Now, if we see the d square, we are just rearranging this, d square becomes W by this one, this will go to other side chain. Now, let us see the constants, this constants are, this is 10 to the power minus 3, okay, and this becomes 4, and here this is the gram per cc will go to other side 1.31, and this pi will go here, and this will be 10 to the power minus 8, this will go in other side. So, if we see this value, total value of this, this will come out to be W by chain into 97190 approximately, this value, this is the value we are getting, it is 97190, that is why this is in micron. D, so, d grab is equal to under root 97190 approximately to W by, this is the way we get this constant value. So, 97190, so that is the gravimetric diameter of wool is this, okay, under root 97190 multiplied by W under root this sigma h n. So, this is the total length of fiber. So, assuming wool is a circular in cross section and the density of wool here is 1.31. So, this is the way we are getting this constant. Okay. Next method is that by microscopic method. Microscopic method we only use when the fiber diameter is circular, the cross section of fiber is circular. it is applicable to the fiber with circular cross section, okay. A suitable random and representative sample is conditioned for 24 hours in standard testing atmosphere. So, for any fiber diameter measurement, it is very important to condition, because if we do not condition, because most of the fibers are hygroscopic in nature, and by absorbing moisture it gets swelled. So, we will get totally wrong result if we do not get the fibers conditioned. Okay. So, for same fiber with different atmospheric condition, different humidity level, the diameter changes. So, for measuring diameter, we have to first condition properly. Then fibers are cut into suitable small length, because we will measure the diameter in the under the microscope. Very small length we have to cut, and the slide is prepared by carefully mixing the fiber into a mount. Some mounting material should be there, some mounting chemical has to be there. One, the care, utmost care has to be taken for selecting in mount, is that it should not swell the fiber. That is very important. Okay. Fiber should not get swelled. So, the mount is important, because it has to actually place the, keep the fiber in stack in its position when it is placed in the on the slide. The mounting agent should be non-swelling and have suitable refractive index. Okay, normally liquid paraffin is used. Now, why refractive index? Refractive index is here, it is extremely important, because if we use the refractive index of mounting agent which is equal to the fiber, then problem would be that the fiber will not be visible. Fiber will be actually optically dissolved, optically it will be totally vanished, we will not be able to see. So, that fiber refractive index, it should not match with the refractive index of the mounting agent. So, otherwise we will not be able to see. This technique we use when we measure the fiber cross section, and by optically dissolving the fiber, few fibers, we can see the other fibers. The mixing of fiber and mounting agent is spread thinly. So, there should be the mixing, properly mixing, and it should be thinly spread on the slide, covered with the covering glass. So, it should be uniformly distributed, it should not be clustered. The slide is then traversed in zigzag fashion, so that we can take the fiber diameter from different position, different portion, and we can cover maximum number of fibers. Okay. It should be in the zigzag fashion to cover all fibers randomly. This is the way the fiber, the slides are moved. Okay. This way the slides will be moved, so that we take the reading from different portion. So, majority of the fibers are actually covered. Okay. Now, we will continue with this measurement techniques of fiber in the next class. Till then, thank you.